I actually started installing probably about 18, 19. I was on the legal side of car audio before that. Then I came to the...
What do you mean?
Well, I started out in car stereo is actually stealing. And it's true. You know, everyone learns somewhere. And then I realized it's nothing but trouble when I can make money putting them in. So I got a job at Circuit City, my first job to put me on paper as car audio installer, and kept watching people and 12volt.com, how to do this, how to do that. Performance Auto and Sound does those how-to articles, read all those, read how to do fiberglass box, went out and tried it. Spent quite a bit of money trying to figure out how to do it, but now I know how to do it. Fun industry. You can take it anywhere. You can make money on payroll. You can make money on the side, especially if you know what you're doing. You know, there's always opportunity to make money. It's a lot of work. It's kind of a lot of training. Not necessarily training, just learning what to do on what cars, because when you get into the more expensive cars, of course, you can really damage them. I like the industry. To anyone that wants to pursue it, wants to make some money, I recommend it.
So I put the Clown Vic, Mr. John.
Sub-amp speakers. And that.
We got an 09 Ford Escape. Just putting a Parrot Bluetooth. Just got it all wired up, about to test it. I can never find the key. Better than? Oh. It's two man.
John, you mind handing me the speaker? So the reason I even listen to this music is for drum rolls like that. I don't know what the f*** I'm saying.
There's a lot of places online that, like 12volt.com and our website, not to name drop our website, but we do a lot of how-tos to show people what there is, you know, what's behind the car audio installation. A lot of stuff like that in 12volt.com, Performance Auto and Sound, you know, all these people that do how-tos, just read that. And your best bet is just to find one of your local shops that's willing to let you not necessarily work there, kind of intern. You know, you follow people, learn, pay attention, see what they do. And as you do that, they will slowly start putting you on the cars and they watch you while you do it. And then eventually you just get the hang of it. Pick it up from there. I'm
real man.
Yeah. Oh, hell yeah.
Don't be eyeballing my chili. My chili.
That'd be dope if they had that shit.
Jordan was just whining about how he doesn't want to work on this shit. And then we put the camera on him, and he's like, because he always acts like he's so serious, but he's really just a dumb asshole like the rest of us.
Speak for yourself.
See, look at him.
He's got to speak for himself.
Faker.
I'm not faking it.
Faking ass motherfucker. What?
All right.
See?
I'm
trying to the cameras.
Oh,
man.
Stupid.
Right on camera.
Do something off. Do it. Yeah! That's what I'm talking about. Hey, want to see something stupid? Look right behind you. Who's stupider?
This guy right here.
Now that's stupid.
That's stupid.
All right, Gabby.
Want to see something stupider? Hey, want to see something stupider? This guy.
Ready?
Are
you ready for it? That f***ing hurt. Is that wet? Holy f***.
We haven't played that in a long time.
Tone what it.
That black cat.
Leave it unlocked for about a minute. And then you go to lock it, it unlocks first. But like if you do it right away, then it locks.
Lock, so it's
unlock.
It's something with the self-arming, right?
Lock. Unlock. No, it's not self-arming. It just stays unlocked, and then when you go to lock it, it unlocks first. But only if you wait.
Cops must have cut the wires somewhere.
They hid the wires?
They cut them somewhere, so I have to go to each kick panel to grab the front speed.
Darn cops.
I wouldn't say bad area. It's not like East LA bad, but I did grow up in a pretty ghetto area. Oh, it's nothing but trouble when I was younger. Nothing but trouble now, but I just don't get caught now. Yeah, no more. I've spent way too much money at the courthouse paying off old tickets and fines and this and that, and done my time behind bars. Not a lot of time. I'm not like a felon like some people around here, but I've done my time and I'm over it. It's not worth it. More money and more fun out of jail than in jail.
We have it.
GM
No.
How
do you know?
Because the customer called and asked for one the other day. That went up there and left.
So what happens if I look and I find it?
What do I get?
Nothing. So what am I, how do you navigate through this?
I get lunch from you?
No. You shouldn't try to buy your lunch anyway, bro.
Yeah, you're not a gentleman.
No, you don't get lunch from me.
Alright, how do I look on here?
You look on it, you open your eyes and you look on your face.
Oh. Yeah.
Nope.
Perfect.
Okay.
Have fun.
Every time the camera goes on, Jordan walks away. Jordan's doing some dumb
Hey.
I got 99 problems and they all bitches. Wish I was living there. Carefree living, but I'm not Sean or Louie. I'm the drinking nigga, all but the little more. You know I have people to start living large. I control my own life, Charles was never in charge. No sitcom, just got about to drop. Won't even explain the troubles that haunted my mom.
There's our buddies from Vegas.
Gotta represent
John Webb, Charles Gruber, McGreg, Mac, Troy! When we went to see, we met them, when we started Amplified last year, I guess we were chatting back and forth with them, and they were going to CES, and they're in Vegas, so he's like, come by the shop. So when we did that week's Q&A, we went, after they closed, it was like 11:30, we went over there at night, and we filmed the Q&A. They're cool. Instead of like, trying to hold them together and do it, you already have it, you slide it in and quickly.
Yeah,
Alright, I'll take these and shove it back there in that little corner.
All of it.
It'll just go.
Broken before he got here.
Well, he just wants to be able to get to his so
he can pull it all the way out. And then you can get to it.
There we go. Done.
All right.
He's stoked. Oh, now the cup holder doesn't stay down.
Can we have a do not touch sticker made?
Oh, it's probably because there's an earplug here.
Oh,
here,
that's probably because there's an get that shit out of my ear.
How shaven does that look?
Oh, stop shaving your
ear. Like my balls.
You
kill
these
damn flies.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, someone's been in here. There's a Thorky missing.
Don't expose my mop. Mop.
Is it? Let's see.
Can't be worse than mine.
Let's see. Come on. Oh, my God. Let's see.
You got me beat.
No way, man, this is the dude, bro.
I know you didn't gel it back.
Why is it parked down the middle like a egg?
Right now. Tomorrow you wouldn't. So we just got one day of
a true box.
Tomorrow, Allyn will do it.
So, you want to take bad news now or later?
No.
You see that orange cable right there?
Yes. It's for the changer.
Okay, then where are the speakers at?
It's a C230, bro. You're gonna have fiber optic bullshit amps.
What do they do now?
Is that fiber?
Well, I didn't know. I always thought C230s were basic. I even thought you could wire up to the Bose amp, but apparently it's fiber optic and we're f***ed. Because we have $340 to work with. I was hoping to God
that. Turn it off.
I'm just hoping those f***ing amps aren't in the doors. You know what I'm saying?
Even if they are, we need a little bit more money for an amp bypass.
I'm so hungry and my stomach hurts.
Oh my gosh, the two of you.
A ruffle shuffle. Just keep going.
Well,
I can feel it talk to me. Please. Bypassing me will go. Bypassing me will. This guy's trying to flex.
Sneaking up into episodes.
Look at that thing. Look at, watch.
Yeah.
Wait, go. Grab my head and pick me up.
Is it is it down here or
no, higher. No. Oh, you had to ask me that. Well, it's on the rack. The motor's out. They're about to put the new motor in. They ripped apart the new motor to put all new seals and pumps and everything on it. And the motor I got is bad. So now I'm trying to find another motor to put into it. Hunting one down. Just a pain in the butt. But hopefully once it's done, hopefully a week, week and a half, it'll be done. Then it's supposed to go to the tint shop. Get some nice tint on the windows. And then it's coming back here and we're hopefully gonna be putting a system in it. The goal is HD 604, HD 1201. We're dropping the 1201. Two Hertz high energy 12s, Hertz high energy components in the front, coaxials in the back, off a Pioneer 4300 DVD. We can't stress enough that we need your guys' support the most. Without the fans, there's no us.
See, this is a Pete's latte. Spoon's not a coffee drinker, so we're gonna have him try it. Yeah.
I like chai tea.
It's chai tea.
Cold chai tea.
Like a big old swing.
He's like, oh.
Ugh!
I'm not spraying paint on it. Some contact cleaner.
Jeez.
What you working on?
Old faithful display here.
What you doing different?
Hooking up an amp. It was hooked up to deck power before. But
I'm gonna give it a little bit more boom boom.
Run this town tonight.
This is like a gangster walk. We walking a mile, dog.
2 miles. Hey, boss. Old video cavity, boss. Give me some of that cornbread, boss.
Let's see. What are we gonna use, Spoon? Oh, dope. Here we go. We got it right here. Yeah! Look at that!
Look at that, man. Needs to be readjusted. The adjustment. It looks like it's sweeping because the refresh rate is catching it like that, but here's what the curve looks like. So I'm trying to go from here to here. So we flatten it out as much as we can with crossover points. So if we have peaks, we create gaps to compensate for peaks. And if we have a gap, you create an overlap to compensate for the gap, if that makes any sense. There's only a few of you that are gonna know what the f*** I'm talking about right now. And then you fix the rest with the EQ. So when he gets a sub in, we'll have a peak here, and then the highs will roll off. We fix that. Ooh, sh**. Look at that. Take a picture of that. So, we're hooking our guys up at Performance Audio in Las Vegas with a couple of these amplified shirts. I can put them on blast right now. Here's what I put on their label. So I'm giving them some free shirts, so I have to get them somehow. So we'll go ahead and put that on their envelope, and it'll be seen right now on Amplified. So everyone will know that Troy is gay. Sorry, Troy. He's gonna see that and be pissed. He'd be like, motherfucker.
A phone call.
This one right here?
I think that's the only one. I think.
Hi, this is Doug.
Dave?
Yes.
How's it going, Jim?
What?
I want to your shipping list.
Oh, you received an order?
This is John from Home Audio here, man.
Oh, hey, what's up, John?
You I just got your... No, this is John.
Yeah, that's up. Yeah, I said, what's up?
I just got your package.
What, was it made out to the right person?
Yeah, I guess so. That's funny, dude.
We filmed that too, so you'll see it on Amplified. So that's funny.
Spoon Industry shirts we're working on now. I had some prints. They're dirty prints, so I gotta get prints remade, and then I can make shirts. I was gonna order them a couple days ago. As soon as they're up, we're gonna put them up on the SoundMan website, so keep your eyes open for that. You guys will be able to purchase them. I would love to be able to give people free shirts. Starting out trying to make something from nothing, so I can't do that at the moment. So once they're up, if you guys buy them, the bigger I get, the more I can give away for free. So once again, show your support. Make this big. What do I do here? I sit like this and I be as sexy as possible. And just all the people just come and they're like, oh shit, Spoon, here's some money. Here's some money, you just too sexy. You got a question? Question? You do? You don't? You do? You don't? You do? You don't? SoundmanCarAudio.com.